Okay, so the recording cut out on me when I was in the middle of recording the ending of episode 1 and ending of episode 2, and I just realized. So, what did you guys miss? You guys missed me clearing the rest of episode 1, some of episode 2, we got Archon, finally, and both Mew and Archon are 5-star. While we are here, let's talk about how Archon works, because we're going to use Archon basically for the rest of episode 1 through 8, in fact. So how Archon works, basically first ignore the first sentence. So if Archon is receiving a buff, then she will summon two additional electric spheres. So a buff is any positive status effect that will increase the hero's capability in some way. So that's where the first part of her passive comes in. Upon using a 3-chain, the entire party armor and penetration and resistance penetration is increased by 20% of Archon's attack power. This lasts 5 seconds, by the way. It doesn't say so, but it does. So essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to use Archon's 3-chain to apply her buff, and then we're going to use Archon's 3-chain again to keep the spheres going. And then, because we need a lot of Archon's 3-chains, we are using Mana Recycle, which is a skill unlocked by Archon. Likewise, we're using Energy Goddess, or Mew, to generate more blocks for Archon. So our team right now is Archon's 3-chains, and then for those who don't remember Mew's passive, Mew generates blocks whenever an ally taps 3-chain. So this is actually a beautiful pair, because Archon and Mew supports each other pretty well. So now we shall keep going. I'll talk about how I'm using Archon's blocks. So Archon's, it's not always feasible to keep up her buff, and that's where goddesses come in. So we got a new goddess for beating episode 1, her name is Pristina. Pristina gives us, basically she makes sure the enemy can't move first, and then she gives us healing whenever they hit us, and whenever we hit them, we will get healing. So I first wait for two Archon blocks, because the first Archon 3-chain doesn't do anything. The second Archon 3-chain, and all the precedent ones while Archon has her buff, will summon the electric spheres, which will deal most of her damage. And then let's say my buff ran out, I could have tapped 3-chain there, but let's say it ran out. And I don't want to tap another 3-chain, so I can use Pristina as a buff, and then this will automatically buff Archon and give my spheres automatically. Any goddess works for this, except for the goddess Anute, who only debuffs. For some reason, the goddess Dione, even though she does debuff only, her goddess activation still counts as a buff for Archon, for whatever reason. So she's an odd one out. However, Anute does not activate Archon when you use her goddess skill. Any other goddess can be used to do this. Useless. And we don't have anything done so far, so let's keep going. So yeah, that's how I'm using Archon. Or also, Sarah ran away in the story, so we can't use her for now. We can use her later, though. This is so sad, though. Sarah left me. I'm all alone. In the sandstorm. We will get Anute when we complete level 24, which will be coming up soon. Again, I'm waiting for at least 5 Archon blocks before I start tapping, because I know by then I will be guaranteed at least Archon's buff by the time I get a 3-chain. Yeah, then we can either let Archon's buff carry over, or we can use Pristina's goddess bar. So in this case, we can let Archon's buff carry over. We don't need goddesses, really. We'll start spamming goddesses in like episode 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Episodes 1 through 4 are trivial. Especially with the amount of freebies they give, like fishing. Okay, I'm banning fishing for myself. I'm never gonna fish. Fishing basically beats the entire game. You get pages, you get books, you get iron, you get crystals, you get powder, you get everything. It's just like you get gold, free gold. Or basically sitting at doing, you basically get gold by doing nothing. It's almost kind of. It's basically cheating, in fact. Like, this system almost should have never existed in Crusaders Quest, but it does exist. Which is why we are not gonna ever use fishing, even though I just clicked on it, and I think I triggered the... Yeah, whoops. Please tell me. Oh god. Okay. We're gonna catch one fish, because we are forced to. I should not have clicked that. Okay, never mind. We're gonna catch one fish because the tutorial happened, but I should not have clicked that. Well, you guys can see me catch a fish. So fishing is kind of boring until you unlock auto fishing, and I'm not gonna fish. This is the only fish I'm gonna tap. Fish, I promise. Tutorial, please go with. I know how to fish. Yes, I know how this works. No, you should have hit the edge, and then you get... Oh god. I don't want to tap there. Wow, I got a fish. Yes, I know how to fish. You don't have to teach me. We have like a skip button. Like, we have a skip button for Oven and Fergus. Why can't we have a fishing skip if we know how to fish? Okay, I know how to fish. Wow. Okay. And here we go. Alright, we caught one fish. We're never catching another fish ever again. Fishing is cheating. Screw fishing. We have 10 fish coins. This is a disgrace. No. Disgraceful. Oh, we have the max rows. Let's increase our... I want to keep these 1 stars around for a little longer. Don't be afraid to expand. I'd say at least 50 is good enough for like all... Like Brad Berry's everything. At least 50 in the early game. While I'm recording this, it's... We're 43 minutes away from... daily reset, and then... Yeah, I guess. That's all I have to say. I forgot what we're gonna get. We get something. If we log in 14 days, we get a 4-star premium contract only. And that could be fun. If we get another Able, I swear to god. Yes, you can get in duplicates in this game, and it's very infuriating when you do. At this point, I just expect the worst at this point, so... Alright. Die. Archon's a little strong. Just a little. And yes, there are better heroes than Archon, even though she might be killing everything. There are better heroes, trust me. Let's check if we have a quest. I feel like there's a quest ready. I guess we'll beat episode 2 and a little bit of episode 3 since I kind of messed up my recording. I still have video evidence of part of the Nuzlocke, but I think some of episode 2 is cut out. I promise you no one died, but yeah, kind of annoying. Wait, you're not max level yet, what am I doing? So, I've updated the Nuzlocke rules. So, I banned some heroes that I can't pick or use ever. So, that includes Genevieve, Wolfgang, Cassia, Osiris, Echidna, Reaper, and also all the limited heroes. So, that includes Dizzy, Johnny, Onran, etc. Rem. More Rem, even more Rem. When will they nerf Rem? 370% more armor penetration, and resistance is definitely... Also attack power, it's not a glitch. For some reason. No other hero has such scaling like that. And if they did, at least it was dispellable. Which is kind of infuriating. She can essentially solo your entire team without, and like, you can't do anything. Right now the only counter is like, Mundiok with Beatrice that has a full armor build. You can use 2 damage reduction on Mundiok, but still. Also, we unlocked Ancient Dungeons and Coliseum. We're not gonna touch those until we have at least 6-star units, because I'm scared of 5-star Leons. I have played Nuzlocke before. 5-star Leons hit hard. It sounds dumb, but they hit hard. Even with Sarah, you don't get infinite amount of Sarahs, and they get basically infinite amount of blocks, so. Also, Mana Recycle buffs Archon, in case you don't know. Mana Recycle buffs the person who used it, which is useful because that means Archon hits a little harder if we use Mana Recycle and then Archon's passive immediately after. Also, if you use Mana Recycle, that counts as a buff for Archon, so you can use that buff. Energy Goddess got nerfed so hard though. It's almost sad. Before Energy of Goddess used to give even more SP, and that made Mew Energy Goddess and like Three Chambers broken, or Yowodon with Energy of Goddess broken. Both are still pretty good, just not as broken as before. Stage 20 already. Almost max level, 29. We'll get to episode 5. Episode 5 is when things start to get a little exciting. Not really. Episode 7 is where the test actually begins. Episode 6 and 7. And then episode 8. Episode 8 is arguably easier than episode 7. Episode 8 is more of an HP test. Episode 7 is mechanics. I'll definitely be going over mechanics because it seems a lot of people seem to be struggling with those. So, yeah. Professor Comma Killer. We're not gonna... Well, I'm gonna use Pastino Buff anyways. And there we go. Max level, let's check quests. Skips. You guys can see the war for yourself. Nothing. Those Popo sell old staffs. Yes. I want an old staff just in case. Because I'm gonna be exploiting. I'm gonna be performing a little exploit in episode 3. It doesn't break the game, don't worry. It's just to give me a little head. Immediately. Sadly, that also means we're gonna need Pristino to get our buff up. You only get 6 Archon blocks. Wow, I forgot. You only get 6 Archon blocks every 12 blocks generated. So we got 6 Archon blocks. That basically told me we weren't gonna get any Archon blocks for the next 6 blocks, which means Archon's buff was gonna run out. What we could have done was use the first Archon's Rechain and then wait a little, but 2 Archon's Rechains and 6 other ally blocks also meant we were going to get Pristino. So I wouldn't do canceling that idea. There seems to be a lack of quests. I thought there were more. I guess not. I really did think there was gonna be more episode 2 quests. Turns out I'm wrong. And there we go. A quest has finally been done. The archaeologist quest, I assume. So, about the rule 10 I had added, I basically banned every single hero capable that's been known to clear challenge 7. Or challenge 6 for that matter. So this will be interesting because I don't know any other way to clear challenge 7 by the 7th. So this will test my team ability creation, I guess. Also kind of scared because I don't know how I'm gonna do those stages. Challenge 5 to 7 hidden. Wolfgang banned, Echidna banned, Genevieve banned, Reaper banned, Johnny banned, and it's not Johnny. Johnny doesn't matter. Dizzy banned. What else? Cassia banned, Osiris banned, Reaper banned. Which doesn't leave many good heroes for me to work with. I didn't ban any like support units except Wolfgang. Which. Maybe I shouldn't have banned Wolfgang, because that means I can't use Wizards anymore, but Archon exists. And I really didn't feel like banning Archon for the early game. So, I could have banned Archon for the early game. That would be interesting, doing the early game without Archon. Maybe I'll do that the next time I try this challenge. This is a stage before the boss, so let's check if we have any quests to do. Nope. Alright, so I believe we do the stage twice. 50 keys, nice. Also, I banned friend heroes. So we had to use Lemus for the tutorial, so that's the only time we were allowed to use friend heroes. And so I'm gonna ban fishing personally. I never said it in the rules, but I'm still gonna ban fishing. You guys can fish if you want. Fishing is cheating though, basically. You get ancient pages and ancient books that way. And VIP tickets. There was an interesting challenge where you ban the usage of VIP tickets. That means you have to deal with a weapon you're getting, which could screw a lot of people over, actually. Because then you have to really try hard to reroll the weapon. And you can't even use bridge points for it if you ban that too. Hello. Giant snake worm. Sand worm, whatever you're called. Archon trivializes these. Sand worm it pulled off one attack. Alright, episode 2 completed. Screw you, achievement. Raid is open. I'm still scared about Camilla. How am I going to do Camilla? Anut, Sarah, we got both back. By the way, there is a glitch right now in the game, I believe. It could be intentional. I 100% doubt it. It's about the goddesses. Let's open these up. Useless. Ah, screw you, freebie. I can't use collectible. That's cheating. I don't want to collect all. Here's new quests. Gems. I like gems. So we'll clear that again. Wait, this means it's Colosseum. Okay. This is... Okay, let's not die. That's... Alright, so speaking of which, so we have three goddesses, however, it seems like we can't use the other ones. This is a glitch, I believe. So what you want to do, you can click here, or you can go back to hero and then click foreign team. Either ways brings up the same screen. So if you click here and you click foreign team, and then you can add like another team. So I like to name mine like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So I already made mine here. But you can change the goddess here. So if I want an Anut, then I can change it here. Click that. Goddess changed. However, I'm gonna be using Christina or maybe Sarah. I want the early buff though. Alright, let's use Christina. So for some reason you can't change goddesses. I have no idea why. This appears to be a bug. Because you should be able to change goddesses. Like, I don't see why I can't use Anut in Colosseum. Okay, let's not die. Leon does hit hard though. If we die right now, I'm gonna be so sad. Oh my god. If we die. This quest for gems. I'm starting to regret trying to do this. Right. These teams look like jokes, but it's... Stay away from Marco. There we go. Pristino, root him. There we go. Okay, Leon's dead. Cool. Abel did nothing. Abel needs a soul down weapon. His base reflect damage is only 50%, I believe, which is still pretty high. We can beat this one. I'm scared about the 6-star Sentinel. AI doesn't know how to use Sentinel, but... Yeah. It's a 6-star unit, which means he has like 50% more stats than I do. Which is what scares me. Christina. Able tank that for me, please, thank you. So why I'm not too afraid of fighting Sneak? Viper, sorry. His old name was Sneak. I'm not too afraid of fighting Viper because Able heals off per hit. And thankfully, Viper is the most multi-hit person ever. I don't want to fight Dox. Dox is strong. Dox might be a meme right now, but his base damage from his block is so strong. Season 1 vibes, man. Like, I might sound really retarded for, like, complaining over 5-star units being strong, but they are strong, man. I still have PTSD when I lost in Nuzlocke challenge, basically because a 5-star Leon killed me. Actually, Abel is actually kind of useful. He's preventing them from reaching the backline. Wait, why am I doing round 4? I don't need to do round 4. We only need to win 3, right? Abel, give me a block. I forgot Aria dealt damage that way. No one uses Aria. Alright, let's just win 5 times. If it's like 2 docks or like 1 6-star... is a Monty. Okay, nope, I'm out of here. My stars are OP. Monty, don't fight Monty, unless you have a Monty of your own. Monte deals fixed neutral damage, and it hits all enemies. This is really weak in higher Colosseum, because we have like 30,000 HP, 5,000 neutral damage isn't going to do anything. However, my Archon right now has... how much HP? 2,500, he's going to one-shot her with a one single three chain. I'm out of there. Nope. I refuse. Yeah, okay, that counted. Thank you. Well, let's kill Zangor game for the quest. Do I have a need to level up? So yeah, that's why I didn't want to fight Monte. Abel might save me there, but at best what he'll do is he'll kill Monte, but also die himself. And Monte will have killed my entire team by then, so they win. Sorry guys, I'm just really paranoid over like Colosseum. I have so many losses in Nuzlocke from just Colosseum. I just underestimate the enemy team. Because like my team right normally would beat them if we were at 6 star. We're not at 6 star though. Which makes it makes quite a bit of difference. You have to like adjust to the different conditions. It's a lot different than we're using. On the other side though, this challenge is really fun. It makes you a lot more conservative rather than take all the risks. We can, however, level up heroes as we go along. I'm not too afraid here. I am afraid of Fortress of Souls though. Oh god. How am I gonna do Fortress of Souls? Ugh. So, after we do this stage, we're gonna unlock Fortress of Souls. And depending on what's on who got started last week? Dido? Right, Dido. Depending on what player Dido has in his Fortress of Souls, I might fight it or I might not. That cutscene is actually hilarious if you have three sirens. It doesn't make sense, but it's cool. Five rounds? What? I thought it was three. What happened to three rounds? Why is it five rounds? Oh, whatever. And we're gonna clear fine, but I definitely don't remember it being 5 rounds. Skip. Die. Thank you. I thought they made all the stages 3 rounds. I guess they couldn't make Fortress of Souls one. Or it's the entire episode 3 5 rounds. That'd be annoying. Excellent. So, what about Fortress of Souls? Should I go for it? I'm afraid. I'm very afraid. You don't understand how scared I am right now. Defeat the green anglefish. Alright. Thank you for stuff, Helon. By the way, go here, go to favorites, and then you can put stuff down. So we can put the stuff for now. I'm gonna put Fortress of Souls here, that's where I usually have Fortress of Souls. And I don't use these two very often, so I'm gonna leave these two blanks. I usually put Challenge here and Legend of Primal Flames here. We'll get to that later though. So we do have to watch this cutscene, unfortunately. There's no way I can skip this one, sadly. So you guys can read this. Basically, there was a war, Apostle War versus Forces of Darkness versus Forces of Light 100 years ago. So basically the story goes, there was a great warrior, Oren. He had a sword, or a Danian's sword, and then he destroyed the blade of Danian. And then now all the weapons of Danian are in his fortress of souls that he resurrected. So yeah. Oh wait, I didn't show you guys something. Why does Reaper have to be in? Why is... He doesn't have Soul Iron weapon, so... He doesn't have the Reaper Slash, does he? His block skill deals so much damage, though. Okay, so Reaper without Soul Iron weapon isn't too threatening. Yeah, so we actually should be fine. He doesn't have a soulbound weapon. What was the other hero? Fenrir? Fenrir can't do anything without soulbound weapon either. Alright, so... let's give this a try. Hopefully I won't die. I'm gonna take Pristina with me. If I die, I will be extremely sad. I don't think Fenrir should be able to Reaper should be able to trigger his soulbound weapon passive. If he does, then I messed up, but I don't think he has 6-star weapon, so yeah. If I fail the stage, then... oh yeah, this is a 6-star Archon, by the way. I have the 5-star version. Hi, this is you in the back, by the way, Archon. Titles. I wish they chose some worse heroes for him. Congrats on your top 3, by the way, but... it's kind of... unnerving when Reaper is in there, and I only have 5-star units. The fog is down. No Reaper. The Reaper mark is there, but no Grim Reaper. Thank God. Also, the Reaper can't reach Archon. Thank you. The buff present is on. Let's try to keep Abel alive. Alright, so... yeah, okay. Thank you. They couldn't do anything, thankfully. Abel did somewhat almost die, but... that was because Fenrir debuffed his armor and resistance, and Reaper had a healing debuff. Thankfully, no one was able to hit Archon. That's the important part. Okay, so this is a Soulbound weapon tutorial. We can't skip this one either. Very sad. By the way, this is where we're gonna do the exploit. Yes, I know. I'm well aware. Nope. So... okay, I don't have to exit out of the game. I saw I might have needed to restart the game. Thankfully, the exploit still works. So, how the exploit works? This old weapon, it will be guaranteed to be... it will guarantee to belong to a hero that I already have. However, soulbound weapons can only be given to 4-star or higher heroes. The only priest I have is Mew, so that means I'll be guaranteeing the Mew as soulbound weapon. While I do want soulbound or Mew soulbound weapon, I want Archons first. So I'm not gonna use this for now. However, thanks for a free Old Orb, I suppose. Screw the sword, also. Screw it, man. I'm salvaging this.